Hi children, welcome back. Welcome back to today's new video. Okay, so in the last video we have discussed about the water and what is water and its characteristics and its uses of water. Okay, then in this today's video we are going to discuss about the importance of the water and the sources of the water and the storage of the water and the water, what is water cycle. See, these are very easy points that I have not used to board today. See here, importance of the water. Okay, is the water is important for us? What do you think? See children, water is most important for us, because without water we cannot imagine our life for minutes also, for 1 second also. See, if suppose I did not drink much water in the morning, is it not possible for me to sit here and make this video for you, isn't it? And even if you not have drunk the much water, sufficient water, then you have not been like this energetic and you are sitting and looking at my videos. It's not possible, because water is very much important for, especially for the human being, that is to drink. Because we need lot of water content for our body. We need water for drinking. And then even along with us, other animals also drink, and the plants also use the water for the like drinking only. Okay, even plants also use water with the help of the roots and with the help of the leaves. Plants are going to suck the water, just how we are going to drink. Even the water, plants are also going to use the water for their digestion and their keeping their water level within their bodies. Okay, so like this they also need the water. Water is most important mainly for the drinking. Then other than drinking, we use water for many household works. Many household works means, see here, for each and everything. I want to wash a spoon, I need water. I want to wash a very small spoon, okay, smallest of a spoon which I have in my house, I need water. I want to wash a whole house, I need water. I want to clean my clothes, I need water. I want to clean my myself, that is my body, then I need water. I want to clean my my bedroom, I want water, isn't it? Then the water is most necessary for washing, cleaning and maintaining its temperature, getting its shining. Okay, it's very much important. Without water we cannot imagine our life. So like this is what the importance of the water. And then we know that like this we use the water, these all are the uses of the water. Then have you ever wondered, or have you ever thought that from where we are getting the water? Yes, we get water mainly from we can say tap, isn't it? But have you ever wondered from tap where from where the water is going to come? See here, the main sources of water is rain. Okay, from the rain it is going to collect in the ponds, rivers, ocean and small lake. Okay, and bore wells, we can say bore wells. And so like this we get this all. And the falls will be there. Have you seen many falls? Jog falls, like Gokak falls will be there, no? I think you might have seen wells, open wells and the bore wells, lakes, ponds, rivers, oceans and the rain. The rain is the main source. Then like this we get the sources of the water in nature. Okay, that these all are outside of the house, these are not in our inside our house. Then what are the sources of water in that is artificial? Artificial means man-made. And then we can see in our house, we can using the buckets, we can use the tanks, we can use the syntex, isn't it? And we can use other barrels. So these all are artificial method of storing the water. So like this we can store the water. We can build a tank under just in front of our house, and we can store the water in the syntex, and we can store water in the barrels like this. So like this we can store. Nowadays we are using the plastic and the cement tanks and steel tanks to store the water. Then have you ever wondered how in the previous days the water is used? In the previous days, water is used to store by using a pots, like mud pots. Okay, they were not having like cement tanks like what how we have, and the syntex, plastic syntex like what barrels what we have right now, those don't have those tanks. And they used to make a tank like structure inside the ground, and even they were using the mud pots and like brass copper utensils were there. How we are using the buckets and big vessels to store. Nowadays we are using of plastic, but those days it is made up of brass or and the copper. So they were using to those vessels to store the water. This is how the storage of the water is done nowadays, and it has done in the previous days. And after this, I would like to say you that we know that how the water is important and for what purposes water is used, and how we are getting the water, that is sources of water, from where the water is going to come. We know that, and how we are going to store in our house and how it will be stored naturally, what are the sources of the water, we know that already. And I want to tell you, I said that is main source of water is rain. Okay, if there is no rain, even there is no water in the river, pond, lake, or in the falls or in the ocean. Of course, in ocean we cannot see any changes because it will be of biggest largest amount of water will be stored. And if there is no rain for 1 or 2 or 3 years, we may not get much differences in the ocean, but in the river we will get river, well, bore well, okay, and small pond, lake, and the falls, isn't it? These all are the, and the small artificial man-made tank will be there in a field side in front of our house. If there is no rain, there is no water in our water tank, big water tank, and there is no water in the our tap also, then there is no water for our house. There is no supply of water at all. Then what is going to be happen? If there is no water, then water will not come in the tap or in the river or in the lake. Then we are going to face the shortage of the water. Then water should recycle. Isn't it? Water should maintain its cycle or its level. Then how it is going to maintain? That is with the help of rain. Okay, if it rains regularly, then the water cycle is going to be maintained. Then how the rain is going to come? So with the help of the water cycle. I think you might have learned, children, water cycle. With the help of water cycle, the water is going to be maintained. See here, water cycle means, first we have here some sources of the water like this. Okay, then here we have the sun. Okay, and the sun rays are going to fall on the water, so like this. Then this water is get evaporated. Water is get evaporated because of heat of this sunrise. And if once it get evaporated, here it is going to form the clouds. Again, if once the clouds are formed, again there will be a cold climate, and that because of that coldness, it starts raining heavily. Okay, wherever the clouds we can get, it will start raining. Okay, then rain will come to the earth, and again it will flow to the same river or other rivers. Okay, this is how the water will go evaporate and go upside because of the sunlight. The river water or ocean water will get heat and evaporate, and it will go upside. Again in the clouds it is going to form, and again after one day or after some time, these clouds are going to pour the again the raindrops. Again it will come to the earth, and again it will be stored in the any form, that may be the lake, that may be the river, that may be the ocean, so like this. So this cycle will continue. If it continues regularly, then this is called as water cycle. Okay, then how we can maintain the water level? With the help of the water cycle. See, children, children, this is how we can learn the water cycle and the importance of the water and what are the sources of the water. I hope whatever we have discussed in this video, you all have understood it, and I hope you will do and enjoy and you will see this full video. Okay, and before ending this video, I would like to give you a small homework. Children, just draw a water cycle. Okay, draw a water cycle picture and label its part. I will not give you writing part because you are small class. And draw water cycle. So like this. This is sun, this is river, and these are the evaporated water, vapor or steam of the water, and here clouds, and again it is raining. Okay, so like this you can draw and label the parts. I have not labeled here, you have to label the parts. I hope you will do this homework, and in the next week we are going to discuss with the next new topic. Till then, take care, bye bye.